Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today is Wednesday, so we are going to go over some new makeup releases and see if it's wishlist material or not. Last week I missed one. I had the flu, like major flu. I was too sick to film, I'm so sorry. And then I was like better enough this weekend and I was like, yeah, I could film it, but then why not just wait till Wednesday and I'll just skip one. I know it's not ideal, but you know, life happens sometimes and this is not something I can really pre-film. So yeah, that's why I missed one last week. Today we're going over the new releases. I have the playlist for the community playlist linked down below. Samantha Marcher makes this Will I Buy It videos also every week, and she made a community playlist for all the creators that are making this type of video, that you can find all of them on the list if you want to. So if you want to find out some more or find some more fun creators, then please check down that list. I will be on my phone as per usual, and I will be on a Trend Mood, Beauty News Official, and Indie Makeup Spotlight pages to see what's up, what's new, and all the stuff I want to talk about, because if I have to talk about everything, we will be here all day and I'm not going to do that. I'm going to try to keep this short. I never manage, but I am going to try. And yeah, let's just dive into the new makeup, guys. Okay, we are jumping into the new Morphe and Jaclyn Hill palette. This is the third palette they are doing together, or at least the second big one, and they had a Vault collection together. I have the original one, I really like it. I have a few, I think two, Ring the Alarm I think I have, and the darker one, the Dark Magic or Dark, I don't know. That one, I kind of like both of them, it's fun, it's nice color stories. And this one, you know, the thing is, it's another very big Morphe palette with a lot of redundant shades. But if you look at the color story as, you know, as of itself, then I don't mind it. I like the bright pinks with the oranges and the deeper purples and the pop of the yellow. I think it's fun and you can make a very, very nice looks out of this palette. I just think that if they would have added it down to like 18 pans or something, it would be, and smaller pans, so maybe just like the size of the James Charles mini ones, or the ones they, I don't know what they're called, but they've released one, I think 15 or 18 pan palettes a few months back. That would have been perfect, just smaller pan sizes, less shades, because you got a lot of redundant stuff in here. But I don't mind the thing overall. I'm not going to go into Jaclyn Hill and if I like her, yes or no. I don't think that is very, you know, to the point. So I'm not going to do that. It's just that I won't get this. It's not going on the wishlist because it's so big. And I have seen a lot of other brands doing this. This is going to be available, I think, on the 13th, yeah, the 13th of February on the Morphe website and in the Morphe stores, and it's going to be $39. So yeah, it's there. It's, yeah. Yeah. Okay, I am going over to the new skincare brand from Huda Beauty. It's called, I think, Wishful Skin. I think that's the name. It's not Huda Beauty Skin, but Wishful Skin. And she is releasing a enzyme scrub type of product. They are saying that it is an enzyme scrub, a gentle yet powerful exfoliating scrub infused with a combination of pineapple and papaya enzyme, BHAs and AHAs, that leave the skin with a healthy glow. A combination of fruit extracts, acids, and soft exfoliants, this scrub promises long-lasting results in just 10 days. It's going to be $39. I think you can get it from her website. And I think it has already launched. I'm not that sure, but I don't see a time or a date when it is. Oh yeah, available now. It's like in the first line. Available now. So yeah, if you want it, you can get it. I think it's nice. I have heard someone say, I think the Beauty News Girls also said that it's kind of a bit of a double up to have all of these exfoliants in them, have the fruit extract and the BHAs and the AHAs. So you have the topical exfoliant and the deeper exfoliant. I'm not really that down in the whole lingo when it comes to skincare, but it seems like a lot. So I am or yeah, I'm agreeing with them. You know, having a scrub with all the exfoliant like ingredients in one product, it seems like a bit much. But yeah, on the other hand, maybe it's going to be, you know, very effective because of that. So that's, yeah, that's like what it is. It's not going on my wish list because it doesn't scream to me. And I think $39, it's kind of, you know, sort of, it's an investment, I think. And I have to get it from her website. It probably is going to cost me a lot of shipping, a lot of taxes. So no, it's not going on my wish list. But I don't think it's a bad thing that she is going into skincare. Because, you know, why not? Why not, girl? She's doing good on the makeup stuff. So why not start a skincare brand? You know, get some more money. Okay, the next thing is by Bobbi Brown, and she has collabed, or they, I am always seeing, you know, the lady. They have collabed with Morag Myers Co. I'm sorry if I'm not pronouncing that right. They have been collaborating on a nice little collection. They have made an eyeshadow palette, a highlighting brick, and a few lipsticks. And there's also an eyeliner in the picture. I don't know why it's there. I think it's just like, you know, we also have eyeliners and it would be, you know, a good thing to throw in with the neutral colors. I don't know why it's in the picture, but it's there. I don't have any details on pricing, and it says that it's an upcoming spring collection, so I don't know when it's going to launch. I just thought it was interesting because, you know, Bobbi Brown is very, like, I wouldn't say a basic brand, but they are all, they are known for their, like, wearable looks and enhancing your looks instead of, you know, putting a lot of color on. So I'm not surprised by the fact that the eyeshadow palette is a little neutral, that the shades of the lipsticks are neutral. I really like the packaging. The only thing that gets me a little bit, it's not the pen sizes or the way that they are shaped, I don't care. But the stripes on the back of them, it makes me a little nuts when it's like horizontal. When it's vertical, it's okay. And like in the picture with all the products. But in the other picture, when it's like on its side, it's like creating a weird image in my head. I don't know how to explain that, but I don't really like having it like that. The colors, yeah, you know, it's basic. It's a palette you can make some very nice wearable looks out of. You can get good use out of these eyeshadows. I bet you will. And the highlighter looks really pretty. Same with the lipsticks. It all looks wearable. And I must say, I don't really mind wearable collections because in the end, when you buy your makeup, you just want to use a lot of it. And if it's something that fits your aesthetics, then you will get a lot of use out of it. When it comes to eyeshadows, I don't really think Bobbi Brown has the best quality. So maybe if you want something like this, you can also go Laura Mercier, or you can go MAC, or, you know, practically anything, to be honest. Or just an Anastasia Beverly Hills palette, the Modern Renaissance or something like that. You can get these shades. It's not like you can't get these shades anywhere else. Maybe NARS has a nice variety of these. Now, yeah, NARS can make some very nice wearable palettes as well. And the eyeshadow quality is a little bit better than Bobbi Brown. But yeah, it's not going on the wish list. It's just, yeah, I just wanted to mention it, really. Okay, then I'm going over to MAC. And I have two things to talk about from MAC. And I was like, okay, are you going to pull a ColourPop on us, MAC? What is happening? The first thing is the new Fix Plus. They have a Magic Radiance one coming soon. And it claims to be an all-day hydrating spray with vitamin C. So it's like an infused skincare makeup type of deal. I have no idea if it's going to be as effective as the Fix Plus. Because, you know, I think it's just the same formula with just some extra vitamin C thrown in there. Because the hydrating property of Fix Plus is already kind of there, I believe. So it looks nice. It's not something I am going to go out and try to find, but it's, yeah, it's going to be there. And yeah, I don't know if it's, if, you know, the thing is though, Fix Plus you use over your makeup, so you put vitamin C in there to do something for your skin, but your skin is covered in makeup, so is that going to be really effective? Is there any sense or use in putting some vitamin C in this? You can answer that for me. I don't think there is. Then the second thing, and it's kind of funny because I think we have been talking about a new, the Loud and Clear collection that MAC is launching, I think not last week, but the week before I was talking about this. And now they have another collection coming out. And it's coming, I don't think, yeah, coming soon. There's not a date yet. There's no prices, nothing. There, you can see in the picture that there is a highlight type of deal, some lip glosses, a Fix Plus, and some lipsticks. And also, I think some brushes, or one brush. I think this might be something that is just going to launch on the Asian market. I don't know for sure, but I have a feeling. It's called the Sherry Blossom. Yeah, the Sherry Blossom collection. It's for spring 2020. And I think it's mainly targeted to the Asian markets. And I have no clue if it's coming to the USA or to Europe or anywhere else in the country other than just Asia. But we will see. It looks cute. The matte packaging with the pink. It looks cute, but yeah. It's normally it's just repeats for MAC. They are re-promoting the same stuff. They already have stuff like this in there, or the products in their collection. They just give it a different kind of coat, different packaging. So yeah, it's not going on the wish list for me. The next thing is definitely on my wish list. I am praying that this thing is going to be available. I think so. But it's going to be available after my no-buy ends because I really want to have it. And I'm talking about the Paris Edit palette from Viseart. It's going to be $39. It's already available. And it is stunning. It's just stunning. They also released a few lip glosses, I think. I don't know if I talked about them yet, but I am not going to talk about them right now because I don't really care about lip glosses that much. But they launched before this palette, so there are also a few lip glosses available. And I think they have the same shade names as a few of the few of the shades in the palette. And this palette, it grabbed me immediately. I love those cool toned mauve-y colors, the pop of slightly peach lighter shade, and then those nice foiled shimmery golds, mauves, and then that pop of like steel gray. I don't know, I really, this just had me drawn in, and I really love Viseart. I have, I think, one or two of this size palette, and I got a few of the smaller ones. I love them. I really love the quality. I love the fact that you can just sample the brand for not that much money, because we all know Viseart can be extremely expensive. And in this format, it's not going to be too much. And you have enough. You have enough shades or, you know, eyeshadow to play with. Okay, so I've got something on my wish list again, guys. I have gone, I think, with a few weeks of not adding anything, but I'm glad I am adding something to it. Then I am going over to Guerlain. Guerlain, I love saying their name, Guerlain. Guerlain is going to add something to their L'Essentiel. I don't know if I'm saying that right. But they're adding to their L'Essentiel range by adding a pore minimizer and shine control primer. And this fresh, lightweight and mattifying primer is made with 97% naturally derived ingredients for flawless and longer lasting makeup application. There's avocado extract in there and white cocoa bean extract. And both are there to absorb excess sebum. The white cocoa one is there to refine your pores. So yeah, it's $53. You know, it's Guerlain. It's going to be expensive. And the reason why I wanted to talk about this is because I use color correcting when I do my makeup. I have quite deep set bags, so I've got a deeper colored line going under my eyes. It's always there. It doesn't really matter how well I slept, I just always have to color correct. And I've got some redness on my cheeks. I like to balance out a little. So I use green for that and peach for here. And I really like the effect because I don't like to layer a lot of concealer under my eye In fact, I forgot to put some concealer after I put my color corrector on. I'm really realizing right now. And I have filmed before a video before this one too. So yeah, I'm totally concealerless at the moment. But yeah, I'm okay, I think. I'm okay. What do you think? I'm okay. So yeah, that's the reason why I'm just, you know, digressing very much. The reason why I thought this was interesting, because it looks like it would color correct as well. So just even out the skin tone. I'm not going to put it on the wish list, and the reason for it is $53. And I think that is a lot of money for a primer. And yeah, so that's a bit holding me back from this. But I think it looked nice, and the packaging looks really stunning. And together with the foundation, aesthetically very, very pleasing. Then, of course, we have some ColourPop to talk about. ColourPop has launched a Valentine's collection. It contains an eyeshadow palette for $18. Then a Better Together Glitterly Obsessed Mini Trio is going to be $12. I think that's the... I'm not even going to guess. It's probably the Super Shock stuff. Then there is a Tender Love and Care Just a Tint Kit with three shades. Gimme S'more, The Strand, and Cutie Fruity. That is going to be $12. Then you have the Hustler Cream Gel Liner and Color in Metallic Black. It's going to be $6 for the gel liner, and for the metallic it's $7. No, the liner is $6 and the pot is $7. Then you got the Candy Hearts, that's an illuminating face mist. It's not in the picture and there's no price. Then also they have some faux lashes in two styles for $8. Then you have packs. You can get the full collection for $60, or you can get the palette and the lip set for $25. Then there from Soul Body, there's also a shimmering dry oil in soft pink, no price, and then a face and body highlighter in soft pink for $10. And if you buy the set, it's going to be $18. And from Fourth Ray, there's a mini set Stay the Night for $18, and you get a BFD cleansing oil, an AM to PM cleanser, a mellow milk mist, and a rose face milk. And if you want to get everything, the full shebang, it's going to set you back $90. My God, I need a drink. Oh my gosh, that's a lot of stuff, man. Okay, I've got like one picture where you get most of the collection in there. It's just not really speaking to me. I think that the palette has like five very light shades for a 15 pen palette. I think that's a little much. So nothing about this is really screaming to me. Yeah, of course, a Just Tint pack could be nice because you get a nice deal out of that. But, you know, I could just get the colors I wanted. A black liner, girl. I've got them in abundance. So this is not for me. I don't really mind the collection. It's just not something that I'm like really drawn into, to say the least. I'm going over to Beauty Bay, because Beauty Bay have launched their new skincare range. They say that it is inspired, developed, and tested by our team of chemists and skincare obsessives. Our range is designed to suit the lifestyle, needs, and routines of you. Okay, because while life can get complicated, your skincare routine doesn't have to be. It's like paying your taxes. You get a super jelly cleansing for £6.50. I'm sorry, the prices are all in pounds. Then you get a skin fixer clay mask for £7.50. Dot a spot blemish stickers for £5.95. Then you get an acid trip exfoliating toner for £6.75. Then a Skin Hit brightening serum for £6.50. A Skin Hit correcting serum for £5.95. A Skin Hit clarifying serum for £6.50. Then a Skin Hit hydrating serum for £5.95. A Skin Hit soothing serum for £5. A day one moisturizer for £6.50 and a thirst trap moisturizer for £7. It's already available on Beauty Bay. I think the packaging looks really nice. To be, you know, for a skincare, I like the aesthetics of having those soft colors with the white bottles. I really like it. And I think it's nice that they are adding to their collection with some skincare. I know that Beautylish has done the same thing with Good Molecules. Good Molecules. I don't know why I can't say that. That was like the 10th try, guys. Echt, seriously. All right. Oh, gosh. Yeah, so this is not something I am going to dive in because I am trying to form a skincare routine at the moment that is working for my skin, that is going to make my skin less dull, that is going to attack some lines and some discoloration. And I think that I have to just keep on a certain track to make that happen. And I've got some other stuff I really want to try. But I don't think it's a bad thing. It's not a very expensive line, so that's always nice to get some nice skincare for not that much money. Of course, I can't speak on if it's going to work, yes or no, but I don't mind it. I don't mind this. Okay, then something interesting that I might want to put on my wish list is the new Bounce Airbrush Liquid Whip Concealer by Beauty Blender. It's going to be in 40 shades, meant to be used as a full coverage concealer, highlighter or contour, and it contains hyaluronic acid, polymers and peptides. It will be available on February 10th. That's today. I'm filming this on a Monday. And this is kind of interesting because it's, when you are reading the description, it's like hyaluronic acid is in there, peptides is in there, so there is some skincare benefits to this product. 40 shades. You only see the picture with the like toothpicks sticking up, so it's a bit difficult to really say if it's going to be enough for everyone. I hope they learned. Let's pray they learned from their foundation launch. It seems that there is some variety between dark and light, but you know you don't know what's in between there, so you don't know if the shade range is any good. The only picture I have is this, so I don't have anything like swatches or the whole range together, so I couldn't say if the shade range is any good. 40, it seems like they at least they tried. So yeah, I don't really see a price though. No, I don't see a price, but I am interested in this. I think I'm going to put it on the wish list because I am also still very curious about their Bounce foundation. And I'm quite curious to see what this is going to do. As I was saying before, I don't know if you have been following me for a bit, then you know I am trying to find my Holy Grail concealer in 2020. So I hope there will be something that will, you know, work for me. And this sounds interesting. So I think I am going to put it on the wish list and see if I can get to it after my No Buy ends. Okay, I'm going over to Kiko Milano, and I know this is not necessarily, this has been around for a bit and I've seen a lot of people talking about it, but I just wanted to talk about it because it is so stunning. They have launched their spring collection, the Tuscan Sunshine collection. I don't really have the greatest picture here. So I'm going to see if I can find some more pictures because they have like two face products. I think it's like a bronzer, a highlighter and a finishing powder, and the inlays on those things. My gosh. And also the model looks like she's just blessed in the Tuscan sun, sitting in Siena, sipping her wine, enjoying life, enjoying the sun, and who doesn't want that? So it's a good picture. I've been to Tuscany a few times and it's stunning over there. So this gives me all the good feels. The only thing I would like to try are the big face stuff. So the highlighter, the bronzy highlighter thing. I don't know if it's a bronzer or a highlighter. I don't know. And the finishing powder, because they look stunning. And I bought the, I don't know if it was the Tuscan Sun or it was something Tuscan, I think. It was a summer collection and I'm going to get it. It had these packaging and it has this inlay. Oh, stunning. I think this is the highlighter, and I also got the bronzer. Stunning. I really love the product. They're very nice. They show up. The only thing I am a little bit concerned about is that it could be that the bronzer and the highlighter have an overspray, so I wouldn't know what is underneath. I'm going to, we have Kiko Milano stores in Rotterdam, so I'm going to try if I can, you know, swatch them. And hopefully it will be there still after my no-buy ends, because I really want to try this. This looks really nice. Then I'm going over to Hourglass, because they have launched 4 new palettes, face palettes, in the ambient lighting range. And you have 4 shades, so to say. You have the diffuser edit, the dim edit, the ethereal edit, and the luminous edit. And you can get them in some countries, in Sephora, and it's coming soon to Hourglass Cosmetics, and I think it's going to roll over into all their stores. I have a feeling that this is a permanent thing, and I kind of like that, because now you don't have to chase the Christmas packs they do, the Christmas palettes they do that are limited edition. These look stunning. I have one of those Christmas palettes, the holiday palette. I have the gold one. I love that one. It was not last year's, but the year before that. It's stunning. It's stunning. The quality is beyond perfection for me, and I should use it more, to be honest. I was talking to my colleague because she fell in love with Hourglass, because who wouldn't? And she was like eyeing that the ambient lighting palette they have right now, the one that they have right now. So I think she will be very pleased to see that you have these ones, because I have a feeling that this could be, if you pick the right one, you have sort of a blush, a bronzer, and a highlighter or glowy finishing powder. I don't know for sure, because it's not really telling us a lot about what this is, but yeah, I'm already in love. I want to have at least 2, I think. I'm bad. I have no clue what they're going to cost. I don't see anything about pricing. But yeah, I hope this will come to Holland. I am going to put this on the wish list. Oh my god, I am so on a shopping spree at the moment. And I can't be, because I'm on a no-buy. But you know, this is going on the wish list. I have a feeling it's going to be permanent, because it doesn't say anything about being limited edition. So I think I will be able to get this. Then I've got something from Milk, and Milk, I think, has collabed with a Netflix movie, that's called To All the Boys I've Loved Before, and I have seen a lot of people talking about this movie and saying that it's really fun and really something to watch. So I might, if I have it in Holland in my on my Netflix. But Milk have collabed with Netflix to bring out 2 glow oil and cheek duo sets. And they got it in 2 shades, Halo and Glimmer. It's going to be exclusively available on the Sephora app today. And I think that was on the 1st of February, so that's old news. And then it will be in stores coming from the 6th. So it's already available in stores. I think only in Sephora. I don't know for sure, but I would think it's only in Sephora and on their website, not anywhere else, because it doesn't say. Yeah, it looks nice. I really like Milk. I really like their stick formula. I have a blush. I have a bronzer. I have a highlighter. I have a pore filling primer. I'm in love with the brand. I really love them. And I think these colors are really, really nice. And I think even catering to some like deeper skin tones as well. But maybe I'm talking before my turn, because I can't really, you know, say I have quite fair skin, and I'm not someone who is doing the makeup of people who have darker complexion. But it looks like, because some like this bright pink will show up, I think, and the other like deep rose burgundy color could be something that will show up. I don't know for sure, but I think it's nice. It looks really nice. I'm not going to put it on the wish list, because it will be impossible for me to get it. And to be honest, I have enough cream products to, you know, keep me busy before they run out. So it's not something I am going to seek out. Then Laura Mercier have launched 2 new limited edition face illuminator powders. The design on these, oh my god. I was like, okay, this is going on my wish list just because of the design, because they're stunning. But I don't think that's a very healthy way to buy stuff just because it's pretty. Unless it's from Kiko and it's like, you know, $8 or something, then it's okay. But these are $45 each. And they are available at Nordstrom. It could also be that it's limited edition only sold on Nordstrom, so that would be a good thing for me because I won't be able to get them. you have them in two shades, in Affection and Sensation, and I couldn't choose. I really like both of them. I think I would get more use out of Affection if that's the left one. Yeah, because it would be more suited to my skin tone. But yeah, dang, these look pretty. These look so pretty. I'm not going to get them, but yeah, I wanted to touch base on these. Then I'm going over to a new collection or a new release from Afra Cosmetics. They are going to release this on a Valentine's Day. It's going to be a signature eyeshadow palette in the shade Galaxy. That is going to be $32. Then also a signature eyeshadow palette in Sweet Dreams, so $32. I think that's the neutral one, and Galaxy is the purple one. And you also get a lip gloss in the shade Supernova for $15 and a lip gloss in the shade Myth for $15. They look really nice. The thing is, I have never tried anything from Afra Cosmetics. I just got a mini highlighter in Pillow Talk, but I think this should be on my list to try this year, Afra, because I think they always are like, they have this really nice aesthetic, very clean, but they have these very bold colors and bold formulas. So I'm really intrigued by the brand, and then I'm not. It's like really weird because I think they are a bit expensive for what you get, but how could I know? I've never tried them. So yeah, I think I at least want to get a eyeshadow palette or maybe, you know, something like this. I think it's nice to have a 5-pen palette because I am kind of sick of the very bigger eyeshadow palettes. It's just giving me analysis paralysis, like I said with the Morphe clip. I really like that there are more brands who are releasing smaller palettes, because I think it's nice to have a bit of a capsule type of thing, not having to think a lot about it. Just be easy, be quick, be done and out the door. So yeah, I commend them for that. Okay guys, sorry, I just cut off because my battery died. So I might look a little bit different, but you know, let's carry on. As I was saying, I really like the fact that brands are coming out with these smaller capsule palettes because it's easier. And I think that these look really, really nice. If I would get one of those, I would get the nude one. Because as I said, I don't have anything from Afra. So if I want to try them, I would start with the more neutral colors because, you know, purple is one of the most difficult shades to formulate. So it wouldn't be fair to them if that wouldn't work. But a neutral palette, if you can make a neutral palette work, then I might be able to try more of you. So yeah, this is not going on the wish list simply because I am not that enticed by it. So, but I really want to try Afra this year. Okay, I'm going to very quickly touch on Marc Jacobs because they have launched some new products. They have launched a hydrating lip oil and new shades of their Highliner liquid gel eyeliner. The lip oil is going to be $29 and the gel eyeliner is going to be $27. You have 5 new shades for the gel eyeliner, and the lip oil is just a clear one. They look nice, the very bright pink one and the purple one are speaking to me. They look really, really stunning, but I think that the swirl is not really selling them because I'm like, are they opaque? Are they not? What is this? So yeah, they're there. It's not going on my wish list. They look stunning, but yeah, they're there. It's there for your buying pleasure. Okay, I'm going into some indie stuff, and I think I have 4 things. Yeah, I have 4 indie products I want to talk about and then we're done. And I'm not going to get myself, it's going to be a long one again, so I'm sorry. Sugar Pill, they are launching a new palette. It's called the Capsule Collection and this is the pink edition, so that would suggest that there's more coming. And when I first saw this, I was like, okay, this looks really cool. I know a lot of people are like, okay, it's all jumbled up, you don't have the pen sizes are not the same, it gives me the OCD aches. I get it, but for me, I don't care. I don't care about how a pen looks or if the pen sizes aren't the same, if they're aligned properly, yes or no. I don't care. I really don't care. And what I think is really fun about this is that it's like it's looking like DNA strings, and the palette is a capsule. It's a pill. It's a capsule. And I think it's fun to have sugar pill making a capsule pill pellet. It's fun. I think it's fun. At first, when I didn't, when I wasn't able to see the swatches, I was like, I don't know about these colors. But looking at the swatches, I'm like, oh yeah, yes, girl, yes. It looks really nice. It's like pastels, but pastels you can combine nicely with some other companion colors already in the palette. I don't know if you can make a very comprehensible palette, or sorry, look with only this palette, but just, you know, throw in some neutral colors. You can, you have some stuff lying around, I bet. And yeah, so this is not necessarily a palette that is like a complete palette you can make a complete look out of if you are not very much into extreme like colored eyeshadows, but you can use this as a companion to some more neutral palettes if you want to have a pop of color. I have no idea what the quality is going to be because I am not someone who has tried, or I haven't tried anything from Sugar Pill before, so I wouldn't know if their quality is any good. The swatches look nice, but they are, you know, very obviously photoshopped, so who can tell. But I really, really like this. It's so much fun. I love the colors. It's so much fun. It's going to be $42 and it's only available for pre-order now if you are subscribed to their, I think, mailing list. So yeah, the full release is coming soon. Fun. Just fun. I like it. Then I'm going over to Nomad Cosmetics. Nomad Cosmetics have launched or revealed, sorry. They are also already launched. They have 2 4-pan palettes. Quads. Then, Chris, it's called quads if there's 4 pans in, like... Okay. So, Nomad Cosmetics has released 2 quads. And they are called the Encinitas and Malibu California. And you have 2 ones, one with a pop of mint, one with a pop of teal. And I think they're nice. It looks nice. I have no clue what the quality is going to be like because I've never tried Nomad Cosmetics. But I think they're fun. And I couldn't really say which one I'm leaning most to. Because at first I was like, okay, I'm leaning more to the right one with the mint. But now I'm like, yeah, but the pink one with the teal looks really fun as well. So, I don't know. I like them both. I like them both. So, I couldn't be, yeah, I can't choose between the two. I'm not going to get them. But, yeah, I can't really choose which one I would be preferring over the other. I don't know. I don't see anything about prices. I don't see anything about, you know, they have launched. I think you can get them on their website, but I don't see any prices or any info about that, so I can't tell you. Then I'm going over to the new collection from Melt, the Modern Love collection. It's going to launch on the 14th of February in Sephora, but you can already get it on their website. They have a millennial minx, millennial pinks palette for $58, then a metal bond gel liner for $19 in 2 shades, a silver and a rose gold. Then you got a crushed glitter gloss for $16 each, or you can get the set, so 4 of them, for $48. That's kind of a nice price deal, I think. And you can get the Modern Love collection as a bundle for $99. I think you would save some money on that. You would save some, and you would save, you would make a very nice savings if you get the full collection, if you want everything, of course, because it's going to be $99 and you already have the $58 for the palette, the $48 for the 4 glosses, and $38 for the liners. If you get everything for the $100, that's a nice deal. I must say, when I first saw this, I was really intrigued by the palette because it looks, the pink shade look really nice, and then combined with the silver, dark blue, denim blue, I was like, this looks so aesthetically pleasing. But the thing I have with Melt is the same with a more what was it? The More collection. I don't know what they... I can't remember the full name of the collection, but you had the Amore and the Muerte palette, I believe. I don't know. The previous one, the Holiday palette. The thing is, the palette looks aesthetically very pleasing because of the colors. They are very nicely chosen together. It looks stunning as a piece of art. But to put it on your eyes and create a look out of it, that's a whole different story. So I was really sucked into the FOMO of wanting to get that Muerte or Vida palette. And I totally changed my mind when I was seeing swatches, when I was seeing people trying to make looks with it. I was like, I wouldn't use it that much. And I have a feeling it would be the same with this. I would use the pinks, no doubt, up until the I think the light blue, but the other two, like grayish blue colors, I wouldn't use that much. And $58 for a palette that I better be, you know, wanting to use all the shades. And for me, I was very drawn in because of the color scheme, and I think if someone made me a beautiful painting using these colors, I would be over the moon. But as it is right now, I'm like, yeah, but I wouldn't combine those colors on my eyes, though. I wouldn't. Not like, not anything other than just a line or something. And yeah, then $58 is a lot of money. So yeah, I'm not going to go for this. The liners look fun, not going to go for it. And the glosses, they don't even look nice to me. I don't really like those glitter particles, the gray and the black on my lips, or the deep blue on my, I don't know. I'm just not grungy enough, I think, for those type of lip glosses. I'm sorry about that. Okay, and then I got to the last thing, because Shred Cosmetics has released a new eyeshadow trio. It's going to, I think it's called Dark Hearts 2. And they are already launched, because they are already available. And I don't see anything about prices. You can get them on the website from Shroud Cosmetics. And I think, yeah, it looks cool, you know. It's a very deep purple, a very deep green, and a nice red. It looks very stunning. The glitters look really nice under the swatches with the light on them. Stunning colors, stunning. It's just not something I would use, so I'm not going to get it. I haven't tried Shroud Cosmetics, so I wouldn't know if it is any good. But yeah, I just wanted to show you, because I think those the colors look really, really pretty. It's just not something I would get, because I wouldn't get enough use out of them. Okay guys, that's it from me. I had a lot of stuff, and I think it's going to be a long one again. It's probably going to be 30 minutes or more. I'm sorry about that. I need a lot of words. What can I say? So thank you so much for watching. Please remember that everything goes on sale eventually. So hold on to your knickers. Don't jump on this stuff unless it is really, really, really limited edition, and you know you can't get it if you jump on it right now. And otherwise, just wait for a sale and you can get it on sale. You'll be fine. I promise you, you'll be fine. Thank you so much. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye.